All right,
warrior.
Nice.
One of the top. Rin. One of the best legends so far in the set.
This card might be broken.
I think it is broken.
The best legend, hands down.
It might. It's a contender for best legend in the game.
I think so.
Like, easily. Like, it's. It's. Like, the guy's standing there right next to Ragnaros. And. Like, he is way up there. Like, he is next to Ragnaros and. Kel'Thuzad and Loetep and. All of those legendaries that are just really top tier high quality legends that people craft. Well, you obviously don't craft the adventure of legends, but you get what I'm saying. Like, this card is just insane.
Yeah.
And it's not even like they gave it to the class that
didn't need it.
They didn't need it at all. It just pushed them even further ahead. And
God,
the other thing too, yeah, is like, even like, this is almost like a Dr. Broom 2.0 to me. Because even if you efficiently kill this shit,
they've already gotten three other
behind on the board. Because they've got shit on the board, they drew cards. There is no way to efficiently deal with this shit other than just to kill them before they can play it. That's it.
Yeah.
So this card is fucking insane. Okay. I might craft that shit just because. Like, I don't even play Warrior. Warrior is one of my least played classes, but I might craft that shit just to get wins because I got some 10 mana.
Yeah, it's my top card.
Yeah, I think so too.
I wish Priest had this shit.
Oh my god.
Are you wanting
to... if any class, if this was a neutral card, this would be in every deck.
Oh, yeah, hell yeah.
Basically, like, unless you're playing face, this would be in every single deck. This card is insane.
So if you wanted, believe, go ahead. Sorry,
I can't believe they printed this card. Like, my mind is still blown.
I want Arthas, just like this guy. Make
I
it
don't
happen,
know who that is.
The Lich King.
Well, the rumor is that that's going to be one of the big expansions.
Yeah.
What were you going to say, Alex?
I was going to say, if you wanted it in your priest deck, the text would probably be Battlecry, steal 3 cards from your opponent and have them on the battlefield.
Burn.
I'll take it, man. I'll take it.
Anything at this point. Like, if you change cards change text on this card, or, like, switch words around, change a couple words, it'll still be better than anything in Priest right now. I'm sorry.
Sea Reaver.
Interesting card. I don't think it'll see play in the most obvious deck that it's supposed to see play, which is Grim Patron. Because the Grim Patron combo takes place on a very specific turn. And the probability of getting this card on the following turn is just not... Like I said before, Grim Patron works a lot like Miracle Rogue, and every single card in the deck has a very specific purpose, and you need to be able to decide when to play each card, and I just don't see this card in the Grim Patron deck, because a lot of the time, more than 50% of the time, it's just going to be a Boulder Fist Ogre that probably loses you the game because you didn't even have the Grim Patron combo on the board. So I don't think it's very good, but it could spawn a new type of deck, like a Enrage Warrior, which has been something people have tried to do in the past that didn't really work out, but it could work out. We don't know. I think the concept of the card is really cool, because it is a negative effect, but it can be used in a positive way in the Warrior deck. Just not with Grim Patron.
I'm gonna make it work.
Make it work. The probabilities are against
my
you.
Existence is just to make you wrong.
Moving on. Next one, Alpha.
So what do you think about that card, Alex? Sea Reaver.
Oh, Sea River? No, I don't like it.
I think it should have been a pirate also.
Yeah, yeah, that's I totally agree with that. It should
like
totally
not agree. Even it doesn't even matter because pirate warrior. I mean, like it maybe have been played like one day out of the year last year, but just because
yeah.
It should have been a pirate.
It's in the fucking name, Sea.
Yeah, yeah. It should have been a pirate probably. I don't know what this next card does. Let me read it.
It says it damages the things next to it.
Alpha. Also damages the minions next to it. Okay, so this is like mini Full Reaper 4000.
Yeah. It's okay, I guess.
The thing is, it's slow. Like, it's a 4 mana 5-3, and it has to attack. It doesn't say damage, it says attack. So you have to play this card and hope that it lives so that you can trade it and then possibly board clear your opponent. I don't think this card is good.
I think it's okay.
Yeah. You gotta time that. I don't know.
You gotta time it so hard. And
yeah.
See, with Full Reaper, he has a lot of health. And it's later on in the game, so you could play it like after you have board control, but on turn four is still like a really important turn to develop the board. That's when like shredders and shit are coming out. So I just don't think this card it will stick to the board long enough to make his effect good. Like his effect is really good. You know, if you were to be able to hit three minions for five attack, that's really good.
Yeah.
But it's just not. Like, the stats are not, like, the attack. Actually, it would have been better as a 3-5, because it would be able to live longer. Like, it would have a better chance at living and being able to attack. And also, the thing is that nothing before 4 mana really needs 5 attack to die. Other than the druid card with 5 health, the 2-5, and spider tank, so it's kind of a waste. Even
I think they were thinking of enrage with this card.
What do you mean?
Like damage it with something, enrage it, and then it'll be like a
7-1.
No, so it'll be like a it's 6-2? Like
3-3,
so it's a 8-5.
No, I meant the one card where it's like a 2.
I see what you're saying. So you hit it, you enrage it, and then you buff it with the +3/+2 from Rampage, and then you hit some stuff, and then you do 8 damage to 3 minions.
Yeah.
That's a terrible combo. Like, why not just Cruel Taskmaster it and be done?
That's what I said. You hit it for the damage, and then it's.
But even then, it's still not good. I don't think it's good.
I think it's okay.
Like, it could be good in the late game. Like, a one-of copy, like, after you've gotten board control. Just like Full Reaver, like, you just play it, and then they can't deal with it, and if they do play any minions, they just die. So, it's okay.
I mean, I use Enrage now with my patron. It turns out to a 6-5. It's not bad.
The card's called Rampage.
Rampage? Enrage? I forgot which one it was.
It's called Rampage. I just told you. Now you know. I know what it's called Rampage.
Alright, King's Defender.
I don't think King's Defender is good. Three, like, even if they printed a card right now that said 3 mana, 3-3 weapon, I don't think it would see play. Because Fiery War Axe exists. And you play your Fiery War Axe, you hit something on turn 2, then you hit something on turn 3, there's no room to play this card, so it doesn't need to exist. And that is that.
Garbage. Sparing partner. I think it's okay. Great card.
I think it's a good card.
Yeah.
It goes along with Bolster, which. Before, I believe Dylan said Taunt Warrior was not going to be a thing. like before we saw all of these taunt cards. But I said, well, maybe I was talking to Alex actually. But I said I would probably still play like Annoyatrons and Sludge Belchers, and then I would play the two Taunt Givers, the Sun Fury and the Defender of Argus, and it would make Bolster almost like a Savage Roar, almost. And that could be a pretty cool deck, not only to use it as burst damage, but also just to buff everybody on the board. And that is a fucking aggro deck's nightmare, to have to deal with 3-4 Annoyatrons and 5-7 Sludge Belchers and just random minions with taunt that they got from...
Yeah, this guy is good even for like late game too. I really like this one.
Sparring Partner and Bolster, I actually like those cards. It might spawn a new type of warrior deck that is not Control Warrior or Grim Patron garbage. And I'm all for that. I like those two cards. I think we talked about Alexstrasza's Champion. It's a pretty good card. The thing is that dragon decks are not normally aggro oriented. So having a 2 mana 3/3 charge is not that good as a control deck, but it's still good. There's no reason why you wouldn't play it. And Bash is good. It's just good. There's no reason. You don't need to justify it. It's just good. This Aspirant card.
Give your weapon plus one.
I don't think that's good. I just think it's too slow.
And then you're going to be using your hero power most of the time with warriors, but having a weapon at the same time with this card is kind of iffy.
Yeah, I mean, what are you going to do? Buff your Fiery War Axe? Buff your Deathbite? I mean, yeah, it could work, but the main reason Deathbite is there is to activate Grommish and to clear mid-game stuff, and Fiery War Axe already accomplishes what it needs to do. Like, it just kills early minions. And the thing is, there's no problem with the weapons that warrior use right now. The Fiery War Axe, the Deathbite, and the occasional Gore Howl all do what they're supposed to do perfectly fine. I don't know why you would go to such a length to give them plus one attack when they already do what they're supposed to do. So I just can't see this card being valuable. Also, this card goes into a slow deck, and which would be like Control Warrior, and there is no room in Control Warrior for this card. Those 30 slots are already all taken by much more important cards. Any thoughts, Dylan?
It could work. It's not gonna get played, but it could work. I don't know, sure yet.
There's also, like, the Weapon Warrior that was kind of used in, like, Hearthstone's early stages, where they, like, play the Arcanite Reaper and they upgrade it, and they just hit your face repeatedly and win. I don't know. This card could fit in that deck, but I'm not sure. Like, that deck is not even that good, because to any weapon removal, you just lose. So...
Yeah, I mean, like, when I use Control Warrior, sometimes I hold my weapon until I can kill something that's dropped that's 5/5, usually Lothab,
Sludge Belcher,
or like Sylvanas.
Yeah, so, but that's the thing, like, I'm saying, the weapons, they already accomplish what we want them to accomplish, there's no reason to buff it.
Like, the only reason you would buff is to kill something bigger. Like, maybe a rag, if it's dropped.
Yeah, but you have executes and big game hunters and shit for that.
So. Yeah.
And shield slams. The thing is, there are so many utilities already in the Control Warrior, you don't need to change them.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Alright, so now we got Neutral Legends. What do you think about Ice Howl, Dylan?
Maybe in Control Deck? I probably won't be playing it, though.
Well, obviously, you're going to use it in Control Deck, because you can't hit face with it.
Hey, silence that bitch.
I know, but you can't silence it the first turn.
Unless you're
you lose the charge.
Unless you're a priest. Oh yeah, you lose a charge.
So, what you gotta do is you gotta play it, hit a card, and then the following turn you can silence it and hit their face. So, that aspect, I think it's okay. I think the community as a whole has given this card so much shit, and it's not really warranted. I think the card is decent. I mean, somebody made a comparison between this and North Sea Kraken, which is a common, but in a way they're almost identical, but Ice Howl is better because, like, if you hit something with the Ice Howl, it'll almost have identical stats to the North Sea Kraken, but have one more health. And then the upside is that it can hit something else, or you can silence it in their face and whatever. So I think some people will actually try it. What I told Alex is that this card would actually be good if it had 12 attack, because then it could kill the dragons, and that would actually be useful.
Yeah.
Like, if it was able to kill a Malagos or Ysera or even Deathwing, just to get Deathwing off the fucking board, it would actually have a niche use rather than just be a big dude that just runs into things.
Yeah, except for Rag. It's pretty good against that, but doesn't really does the job for any dragon.
Yeah. I really like Sky Captain. I'm gonna craft it if I have leftover dust, just because it looks awesome.
Yeah. I just wanna try a fucking pirate deck. And Sky Captain looks really cool for that.
Yeah, even if you get it like at a 2 mana discount, it's still pretty good, because a 5 mana 4/6 charge would be, or charge would be pretty damn good if they printed that card, so I think it's good. It's also like a defensive charger, so it could work in a control deck. It's sort of like a Stormwind Knight, where it has more health than it does attack, so it's good for trading.
Yeah.
So yeah. Chillima, I don't like this card.
I like it.
I dig it.
I think the art is awesome.
The art is awesome.
I'm crafting just for the art.
But the thing is that... seven mana, 6/6 taunt is not very good stats, and then when it dies, you get hellfire, basically.
Yeah.
Which is... I don't know. You see, the thing is, I like to play tempo a lot, and... or not even play tempo, I just play for tempo, and this card is like anti-tempo. Sorry, yeah. I mean, it's really good control, though, but the thing is that the game would have to slow down for this card to be useful as a control card.
And I think it's going to slow down. Except for your stupid mill rogue.
So,
the cancer.
I think it's okay. It's not bad. Like, I'm not going to say that it's bad.
No, I'm using it.
It's not Skeleton Knight bad.
You know? Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
it definitely has a use.
Yeah.
But...
and the best part is anti-aggro. Good job, Blizzard.
I like it. I think if I get it, I'll play it. And I might craft it. If I don't get it.
No.
This was the surprise for me so far.
Really?
Yep. This one and Bowl Ramshield.
Okay. Justicar. I think we talked about this card also. I don't think that it's that big a deal. It might see some play in like really slow control decks. The body is just such a fucking letdown though, because 3 health on 6 mana is a base. So your deck really has to be able to come back from that tempo loss, so it has to be a really slow control deck.
But I tell you what it goes well with?
Control Warrior?
Nope, my Spawn of Shadows.
That's not gonna be a thing, but whatever. Okay, whatever. We already talked about both Ramsteed. Ramsteed. Ramshield. It's good against aggro. But the thing is, in anything other than aggro, this card dies for free because they'll just hit your face and they lose a 6-mana card for no reason. Because by hitting your face, they mitigate the fact that the card has attack power.
Right.
So
it would have to be like Argus or something.
It's going to be... Yes, like, if you can Argus it, it's actually good, because then they can't, like, direct damage your face with, like, skill command and all that garbage. Or their hero power, even, you know? It's just...
Right. You have to combo that card.
If you taunt it up, it's pretty good, yeah. It'll also maybe be, like, a metagame call, like Kazan Mystic, where, you know, if you just see a lot of aggro, you just tech it into the deck. And I think it's a decent card, though. It's a fine card.
Oh, I thought it was bad. You were saying it was bad.
I did say that it's a bad against mid-game and control, but it has its purpose, just like any other legendary that you tech into your deck, like Harrison Jones and all that shit.
Jameer's coming around.
It's like one of those cards. Anyways. Nexus Champion Sarad. I already talked about this card. I think it's too slow.
Oh. Don't cry, Alex. I feel you. I'm here
Alex
for you.
Alex really likes it because the art looks cool.
And I like the mechanic.
Don't Alex cry, wants to Alex. Play this in his tempo mage deck that he doesn't even have.
Don't listen to me, no, Jameer. He's a grump.
Okay, moving on. Gormok.
Best legendary in the set. Oh, yeah.
I don't know. Like,
I think it's okay.
It's garbage.
Trump did make some good... Actually, I think it was Trump and Strifecrow. They both made decent assumptions of the card. Like, there are some decks where it could actually have a use, like any deck with Implosion or Unleash the Hounds.
Or like the Zoo deck.
Right, or Zoo deck, or anything that, like, it can even have a use in Shaman, even, because they're good at putting totems on the board and stuff.
So
it could have a purpose.
Can you choose what this attacks?
Yes.
Okay.
You could target anything on the board.
Yeah, isn't it like it's like a combo card almost, right? You choose when there's enough on the board, you just use it as a combo.
Yeah, well, if you have four cards on the board, you play it, and then you choose where you want to put the damage. It's fine. I think it's alright. I mean, that's basically...
Okay,
huh?
It's okay, then.
Okay. Well, okay. It's okay.
Dark
I think
fan.
It's about average. We talked about the sisters already. They're both pretty good. There is one problem that I have with the sisters, and it's that the decks that they go into naturally, which are Paladin and Priest, because they obviously have cards to buff them.
Mm-hmm.
Those decks already have good cards to play on three. Like, mm-hmm. for example, Dark Cultist, Muster for Battle, Alder Peacekeeper. So, it may be difficult to put this card in those decks. But I don't know. I mean, even in the Priest deck, I don't have a problem playing, like, these two and two Dark Cultists. A lot of my mid-range decks play, like, four minions that I can actually play on three anyway. So, I'm not sure if that's a problem or not. But I think the cards are really cool.
I'm crafting those.
I don't have enough dust to craft that, because I'm already going to spend the dust that I have on a new barrack.
I thought you said you wanted Sky Captain.
I do want Sky Captain, that's the second one I'm going to craft if I have enough dust.
Alright, Frost Giant.
Don't think it's that good. A lot of people said that it might see play in, like, Handlock, but the thing is that after I saw this card, I played some games against Handlock. and I counted the amount of times that they actually tapped, and they would on average play this card for anywhere from 4 to 6 mana, and I don't think that's good enough.
I think it might be good if you combo it with the mage, where you can use your power so many times.
It could be better for a class that could infinitely use their hero power, like mage, or a warrior, or hunter, druid, even though hunter in particular, they probably won't play this card because it's too slow.
Right.
But it's an interesting card. I like the fact that they're still coming out with giants. It's something else that you can get with recombobulator.
Mm-hmm.
If you recombobulate a thing.
If I can get a damn recombobulator.
Yeah.
Photo Rider? 3-5 Photo
Rider is slow. I think basically the whole thing with all the Inspire cards is that they're just too slow. Even if you play this on 8, it's just 2-3-5s, which it does add up to 8-8 worth of stats, but 8 mana 8-8 isn't very good. So, I don't know. I don't think it's very good. It's too slow.
So it's like Ragnaros.
Yeah, but Ragnaros has charge, basically. That's why he's good. Grand Crusader, I don't think getting a random paladin card is worth one mana. Actually, it would have to be worth more than one mana, because a 5-mana 5-5 is not really something to write home about.
I'm surprised it's a common, though. You're getting a paladin in any deck now?
In a neutral, yeah. Actually, that's another thing. Like, a lot of people are upset because there's even another card that will give you, like, a dude. And it's a neutral card, and they're like, why are they just giving out paladin cards all of a sudden?
Yeah, right, the recruiter. That's coming up.
No, not that one.
There's another one.
Yeah, there's another one somewhere. Like, it's Inspire, and you get, like, a dude. And basically, it's just that it fits the Grand Tournament theme. That's the only reason why they're doing it. So, yeah, I don't think Grand Crusader is that good. It may be good in Arena. I don't know. Like, sometimes you have to pick up a card in Arena that'll give you more cards. That's because you don't have enough cards in the deck, or you're enough card draw in the deck, or your mana curve is not really that good. So, it may be okay in Arena. I didn't know that this next card existed.
The Spell Eater?
Battlecry, copy your opponent's hero power. Now, that is pretty interesting.
So, does that keep it the rest of the game?
I believe so.
Yeah, it does.
That's interesting because the game has been balanced in such a way that certain classes would become broken if they had other hero powers. For example, the Warlock. The reason why they give them shitty cards is because, or not shitty cards, but cards that have like pretty significant drawbacks, is because their hero power is so strong, just being able to draw two cards per turn if you want. So, if for example you're playing Hunter, and you copy the Warlock hero power, that's potentially a problem, because if you let the Hunter just keep drawing cards and playing their class cards, that could get out of control. The thing though is that this occurs very late in the game, so like 6 mana, I'm not sure, like, I don't know how significant it would be to copy somebody else's hero power.
Yeah, Noxious really liked it.
So maybe. It's a very cool card, for sure. And it definitely has an effect that it warrants being an epic, because it's a very strange effect. but I'm not sure how strong it is. It's probably not good in arena because just the base stats. But it's pretty interesting. I'm very curious to see how other classes would do, in particular with the Warlock hero power, just copying the Warlock hero power, because I think that's the strongest hero power in the game. So giving that to other classes could be very interesting. As a matter of fact, they should have probably given this to Warlock so that other people could not copy the Warlock hero power. But I don't know. Recruiter, add a 2/2 squire to your hand. That's an inspire. Now, I got a couple questions about this. How much does the squire actually cost? Like, if the squire costs 1, that's pretty good. If the squire costs 2, that's pretty bad.
Oh, you mean like in your hand as a card?
Yeah, because it's going to get added to your hand.
It's, yeah. I think it's 1.
Okay, so if it's 1, this card is not bad. I think the card is probably one of the better Inspire cards, but still, that's not saying much because the Inspire cards are really slow. I don't really see... I don't know, like, the card is just not good enough. Even in the best case scenario where every turn you get to put a 1 mana 2/2, I don't even see where that's even that good.
It's good if it stays on the board and then you quartermaster it.
Their squire's not Silverhand Recruits.
Oh, damn it. There goes my combo.
Wow. And you'd have to Stormwind.
Dylan, I think you gotta go back and read every single card, like, individually after this, man.
You'd have to Stormwind.
I get the names mixed up, bro.
Yeah, it could work with Stormwind, but again, even in the best case scenario, is that even worth making a deck around? I don't know.
No, I don't think it is.
Yeah. Twilight Guardian. I like this card a lot.
I think it's good.
I think it's one of the better epics. And for a couple reasons. One, because Dylan will say it's anti-aggro, which is good. It's better than Senjin in a way because it has 1 more health.
I talked to Dylan about that already.
The other cool thing is that it's a dragon, and it can activate other dragons. Mm. But it also has a dragon effect itself. I don't think it works in such a way that if... Because they say that Battlecry effects happen before the card hits the board, but I don't think it would activate itself, obviously. But it's still cool that it's a dragon that has a dragon effect. Mm-hmm. I don't think there has been... Oh, actually there has. The whelp.
Yep.
The
garbage.
Whelp.
You mean the garbage?
I think it's pretty good. But...
The priest garbage?
It's the garbage.
It's pretty good. So I like it a lot. I think the cards are good. I think it'll see play. I would even craft it if I get into the dragon tomorrow.
Epic. It's going to be so costly.
400, man.
It's 400. Not that bad. I can make a few of them right now. And I have the least gold dust out of everybody. Crowd favorite is bad. You're not going to make a deck revolving around battle cries.
No, I don't think that, so.
I mean, even though a lot of decks naturally have a lot of battle cries, I just don't think... I fail to see how this card is better than Questing Adventurer, which activates off of every single card. And costs 1 less mana. Even though it starts as a 2/2, but I still think... Questing Adventurer is one of my favorite cards, so... I think I know the card very well, and I don't think that card is better than Questing Adventurer. And Questing Adventurer is not seeing play, so...
Yeah.
Crowd favorite is not gonna see play. Master of Ceremonies. Tits.
Tits?
Yes.
Yeah, she's foxy.
That's why this card won the voting, by the way. I guarantee it. Because it did win the voting against whatever other card that it was going against. And that is the only reason why it won.
And the art is pretty good. It's flashy. And
I believe Ben Brode or some person that works for Blizzard even tweeted about it. They're like, yeah, we already knew how this one was going to turn out. So, you know, it's so sad, but true. I don't think this card will see play. Just
probably not.
Even if you get the effect off.
6/4?
It's a 6/4 for 3 mana. I don't even think that's good enough to make a deck around. And there are no decks with a lot of spell damage in them. Like, there's... Like, rogues use Malygod sometimes, and they use Azure Drake, and they use Blood Mage Stalnos. And even that deck, that's basically the most spell damage you're going to see, cannot play this card, so it's probably not going to see play.
I want to move.
Garrison Commander is okay. I don't know why it's an epic. It could have been a common. Inspire is too slow, so I don't see how this is going to work. How it's going to be any good.
Kuldara Drake, of course.
Kuldara Drake is better.
I know.
Oh,
no, I meant, was it Maiden of the Lake?
Oh, my God. Mulgar, champion. 6 mana, 8/5. 6 mana, 8/5, that's not bad. For a ogre, I guess. It's bad. It's just a bad card. In Arena, it might be okay. But that's it. Like, I'm going to be pissed off because this is a rare, and I'm going to get this in a lot of packs, probably.
Oh, I guess you're going to be dusting a lot now.
Yeah, you're going to get a lot of 20 dust.
It'd be interesting if they meet up Ogre class cards. Which I can see.
There are some Ogre class cards. Stealth Ninja? Does that mean Stealth Ogre? Ninja Ogre? Ogre Ninja?
Ogre Ninja.
Yeah, but I mean, actually...
You want an Ogre class?
Yeah.
No, that's not gonna happen.
I don't think they're gonna make another class in general.
Yeah, I don't think they're gonna make another class.
I think you guys are wrong. Dead wrong.
Okay.
Dead.
We'll see it when it happens.
Mm-hmm. It's weird that they're adding all these ogres that kind of work very similar to each other.
Well, they all...
It's the ogre 50% mechanic. Of... That's
yeah. Why not make a class out of that?
That's a terrible class. That would be so severely... Legendary. That would be so severely underpowered compared to the other classes.
So what's your hero power going to be in them?
I do know that, because they're terrible.
No, you don't know that.
I do know that.
It could be like old ogres get like +2/+2. They just need one good card that goes with the class. Or all ogres lose their 50% chance to attack the wrong enemy.
You mean Wailing Soul?
Yeah, but another ogre type card. Or ogre type cards that. Oh, this is all. In theory.
Dylan, I'm running out of voice right now.
In theory.
All right, let's move on. We're moving on to Master Jouster.
It's gonna happen.
I think Master Jouster is okay. It's anti aggro, so it's fine. In Arena, it's probably not good. But in Constructed, it might see play just if aggro.
Yeah.
It's like a metagame call. It's good against aggro, and it'll get used just because of that. Armored Warhorse is bad, because you're not going to win Joust a lot in an aggressive deck.
Right. Yeah. Chances of that happening are pretty low.
Yeah. I mean, you're still going to win some, maybe like 20% of the time, just because other decks have low-cost minions too, even if they're heavy decks, but it's still... Not a good idea. That's a bad card. Also, the fact that it's a beast, I don't know.
Why would a hunter use that card?
Yeah, I don't... It's a bad card. We don't need to discuss it anymore.
Alright, Lights Champion.
It's just a horse.
Lights Champion.
I think it's garbage.
Blizzard believes that demons will become a problem, apparently. So they've already given us the tool that will help us against the demons. Alright, so basically this will silence the taunt on Voidwalker. It will silence the death rattle on Voidcaller. It will silence Mal'Ganis. It will silence Imp Game Boss. It will silence the dude that absorbs the things next to it. What is it called? Void Terror?
Yeah, Void Terror.
I don't think this card is going to see
anything. Well, it'll silence that new warrior card. What is that, the Void Crusher?
It'll silence that one. It'll silence the shitty one, with Dreadsteed.
Dreadsteed.
There are targets out there. It'll silence Illidan.
Who plays Illidan anymore?
It's coming back.
Illidan's never going to make a comeback.
I'll take the challenge.
If you bring him out, Dylan, I'll bring him out with you, okay?
I don't have an Illidan.
I need to craft him.
Oh, you don't even have him. Come on, man.
I'll play Big Game Hunter so I can kill him. This card just won't.
It's garbage.
This is a sucker rare, dude. This is just like the Moger. It's going to be in every single one of my packs. And I'm going to have to dust it repeatedly. Saboteur. I think it's a very interesting effect. It's like a Lothab, but for hero powers, I'm not sure.
I don't know how good it's going to be.
Why would you stop your opponent from using their hero power? It's not even like so much value that they're going to get out of it.
Yeah.
I guess it could slow down Warlock for like Handlock for one turn, but even then, if you play this after they tap on turn 3, they can still play their Twilight Drain on 4. So that's like the biggest thing I can think of, and it's still not important. So I don't think Saboteur is that important. And this is also assuming, again, Blizzard has given us the tools to counter those pesky Inspire decks from using their hero power so many times.
I'm going to use this card against Alex with Caldera Drake.
He'll only be able to hit you for 2 damage.
Value.
This card is bad. I do like the art, though, for some reason. It looks cool. Just the dual-wielded dagger dot guy.
I'm surprised it's not a rogue card.
Yeah, right? I thought it was.
Coliseum Manager is garbage.
And we just passed this one. We talked about this garbage way too much.
Yeah.
Moving on. That thing, coach.
Fencing coach is okay. Like, I'm not going to say it's bad just because of the fact that you can. There is a combo with it, with the Maiden of. I mean, not Maiden of the Lake, the one up there that lets you use your hero power twice. So basically, you can use your hero power twice in one turn for 2 mana later on in the game. And then that could make your Inspire effects actually be worth something, but I just think that there's not enough value there, and ultimately it will probably not see play.
I don't think the Watchman's that good.
Watchman is garbage. Next card.
Injured is another Injured Blademaster, so it's a 1-2-1, and it gets killed easily.
I mean, it's the thing for priests. It's another target for Circle of Healing, so that you can buff it and then draw more cards. And then, in addition to that, I always thought of this, but nobody. I don't think I've ever seen anybody do it. You could put it in a warrior deck and use Rampage on the thing, because it's already like hurt. So you could put Injured Blademaster in this thing in a warrior deck and use Rampage on it.
That's pretty good.
I've never seen anybody do it. It's been a thing that I've been thinking of.
It's gonna happen.
Like I was saying earlier, if there becomes like an Enrage deck for warrior, where they have a lot like the Rampages and stuff, it could go into that deck. I don't know. I just, other than that, it has no use. Oh, and also Resurrection. You can resurrect it as a 2/4.
Value.
Value. Yeah, even as a 1-mana 2/4, though, it's not even that good. Like, it still trades evenly with Zombie Chow.
I got the combo ready, bro. The synergy. It's gonna be like this. This one, then Resurrection, then Velen's Chosen, turn 3. It's game, bro. It's game.
Then he gets silenced.
Talked about North Sea Kraken. It's actually basically a big fire elemental. The thing is just that it's big game. You can big game hunter it, and
but it already has value. It has 4 damage when you bring it
right
up.
It does get, you get a free eviscerate on it. It's a good noob card.
The noob card one shots Confessor Patatris in one shot.
Yes.
Fucking hell.
It's a good noob card. I think in Arena it's okay, because big cards are sometimes good in Arena because you need late game, and you'll basically, I mean, in a world where you'll take a fucking Golem, the 7, what is it called? War Golem. In a meta game where War Golem is sometimes good, I can see North Sea Kraken being sometimes good. So in Arena is probably good. Jormungandr, I believe is how you pronounce that, just because I've seen the anime Jormungandr.
Captured Jormungandr.
Yeah. It's a big beast. The stats are okay. Like, it's not value, because if it was really value, it would have been like a 5-10 or a 6-9. So it would have like one more than twice the mana cost. But it's a beast. I guess that's where the 1 point went. It's just a really good card for trading. I think it would be good in Arena because it has 9 health. You could kill a lot of shitty minions with it.
Clockwork Knight.
I'm not sure if it'll see play in the mech decks. Like, it could, and it's also worth noting that it's a mech itself, so if there's one already on the board, you can buff that one too. I think it would have been better if it was give +2 attack instead of +1/+1, because generally the mech decks, they're not going to utilize the health. It's just better to have more attack, probably.
Again, you use Stormwind, and it already has it. And it gets it to everything.
But, I mean, it's a lower card. It's better tempo than Stormwind, because it's a 5-mana 5-5, where Stormwind is 7-mana 6-6. But
no, isn't it? It's
on
a
the upside,
6-6,
Stormwind, huh?
Isn't it a 6-6-6?
No, it's a 7-6-6.
Huh.
On the upside, Stormwind does give everybody +1/+1.
That's what I'm saying.
I don't know. I don't know how to value that. I mean, it's not even that important of a card, so whatever. Mukla's Champion is garbage. Moving on.
Yes.
Pit Fighter. I'm actually glad that there is now 5-mana 5-6 with no text at all. It's just good, because it gives noobs something to use. Just, it kills Sludge Belcher. Like, it outright kills Sludge Belcher. It kills the Sludge Belcher and the Slime. And it's still alive. Like, it'll be a 5-2 after that. So that's awesome. It kills Loatheb and it's still on the board. It's just really good that we have a baseline 5-mana card.
It kills Sunwalker, too.
And it could actually see play. It kills Sunwalker. Yeah, it's just a good card. Yeah, I mean, these base cards don't normally see play, but it's going to be, like, top tier in Arena.
The art.
I actually didn't even know that this card existed until I just saw it.
The art's terrible.
Are you serious? Like, I just gave some, like, legitimate reasons why it's good, and you're just going to say it's terrible.
No, I
it's
said
also good in Priest.
No, I meant the art is terrible, not the stats.
Oh, the art.
It looks kind of weird, I guess.
Yeah, whatever. I don't care about the art. It's whatever. It's fine. Whatever.
Alright. Raider.
Valdir Raider. I'm just going to pronounce it like that. I'm going to assume that the K is silent. Because I'm not going to say Kvaldir. That sounds retort. It's... Okay, so this is... Let me tell you what this is. This is...
The Watcher. Seven mana.
Floating Watcher for a common. Like, it's a neutral Floating Watcher. Like, you can literally put two of these in your Warlock deck and have four Floating Watchers. Do you think that's a good idea, Dylan? I think that's a bad idea.
Well, then you have to put two Facelesses in there.
I think it's good with other classes, maybe.
I don't know.
Maybe with the priest.
It could be good with priest, actually. Like, yeah. You can just repeatedly kill things and heal it, and then you get, like, four health, two from the heal, and then two from the hero power.
Yeah.
It's just slow, but...
And you don't have to worry about Light's champion.
Wow. Alright. Frigid Snowbold. I don't even... That art is hideous.
It's pretty bad. I like it more than Pit Fighter.
I'd take Pit Fighter over that any day.
Now you're just pushing my buttons.
It's a 2/6 with spell damage plus 1. I'm not sure how good that is. It's kind of whatever. I don't think it's going to see play at all.
Nah, I don't like it.
Maiden of the Lake might see play if these inspired decks become a thing. Stats are okay because it's kind of sticky with 6 health. I don't know.
Start pinging shit off the board, man. Ping, 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 ping.
This next card... Battlecry, restore 4 health to each hero. Why the hell would you want to do that?
Yeah, I don't think it's that good.
I mean, it's an anti-aggro card. Yeah. The thing is that it has decent base stats. Like, it's like Ascension, just without the taunt, and then you get 4 health back. I don't think... this card is not better than Ascension.
No. It's alright.
Yeah, it's
anti-aggro. It's okay, my book.
You can't just make a 30 card deck with an anti-aggro.
Challenge accepted.
I mean, yes, you'll beat some face hunters, and that's it. You'll beat some face hunters. You'll beat some face paladins, and that's it. You're gonna lose to everybody else.
I'm gonna record that shit. I'm gonna send it to you.
I'm recording it right now. It's gonna be on YouTube. I'll link you to it when it's up.
I'm gonna send it to you.
All right, moving on. The medic.
The medic is okay. This is actually really good anti-aggro. Like, if aggro becomes a real problem, we just put two of these in every deck and we win every matchup that we draw it.
I mean, use this in priests and it's already broken.
Yeah, just this card is anti-aggro written all over it.
Nom nom.
Now, this next card, I have a huge problem with it.
Heckler?
It's a 4 mana 5/4 taunt. Basically... See? Basically, somebody at Blizzard, who gets paid real money, they sat there and they saw a card, right? They saw Booty Bay Bodyguard, and they said, yo, I got an idea. Let's reprint Booty Bay Bodyguard, but let's make it 1 mana less and change the picture and the name. And for all of this that we did, we're going to put it in a pack, and they can get it as a common. And that motherfucker should get fired. This...
I mean, it's like Ascension, though, except it has 1 less health.
Well, it kills Ascension and is still alive. Right. And they're both on
4
mana. But my problem with this card is that it's Booty Bay Bodyguard with 1 less mana. And everything else is the same. So why the fuck is... Are they going to buff Booty Bay Bodyguard?
They better. Or make this into a 5/5.
They should make it a 5/5. I'm not even kidding. They should make Booty Bay Bodyguard a 5/5.
Yep.
Just because this card exists now. And they're not. Because they're going to be like, that's part of the game, guys. You have to determine the good cards from the bad cards. That's why bad cards exist. But... Really, that's a dumb. Which brings me to the next card. We're going to skip the one and come back to it. We're going to go straight to Ice Rager.
The 5/2?
which is Magma Rager, but it has one more health.
True.
Why? I bet you the same motherfucker that invented Evil Heckler invented Ice Ranger.
It makes no sense. Like, it dies to everything that you put up.
I mean,
so why wouldn't it be a 5-1?
What point are they trying to prove that, what, Ice Ranger, even though it's strictly better than Magma Ranger, is still not going to get played? So what kind of point are they trying to prove? It's stupid.
Yeah, it's pretty stupid.
What they're going to do is they're going to add an elemental class. Oh! You heard it here first. That's it.
You heard it here first on my video?
Yep.
Thank you, sir.
All right, moving on. The writer.
It's just stupid, and I just feel cheated right now because they just put two cards that basically existed already in the expansion that we're going to have to get now and dust them because somebody was just lazy to create two more cards.
But they made it a little bit better.
All right.
It's stupid. Okay, Dragon Hawk Rider. All right.
Cain Wind Fury.
Cain Wind Fury this turn. It's okay. It's not going to see play or anything, but it's okay.
I think I might see some people play that card.
We're going to see people try and
build a rogue with it?
Oi, rogue, baby.
Maybe. I mean, yeah, but then that would require conceal again. So, I don't think so. But here's a different idea. Warsong Commander. Like, you can charge it, and then buff it, and then armor up, and then Wind Fury. It's okay. It's a combo card. I don't think it's going to see play at all. We talked about Argent Horse Rider. It's okay.
Yeah, it's okay.
It's actually sort of anti-aggro. Because they can, like, kill Knife Juggler and still be there on the board. It could be also pro-aggro because, obviously, it's a charge card. So it's okay. Silent Knight is okay if you don't have... I mean, the role that it plays is like a buff guy. Like, it's stealth and then you put buffs on it and then you win the game. So it's okay if you don't already own Shaden Axe Rammus, I guess.
Right.
It's like a new version. It's a new version of Shaden now. Axe Rammus. Here's the other card that gives you Paladin cards.
Oh, the Silverhand Regent?
Yeah. So, Dylan, you can combo this with your...
Blessing of Kings. Synergy!
No.
Quartermaster.
Oh my god, Dylan.
Oh yeah, that one too.
That one too.
But overall, I don't see what the purpose is of giving every class Silverhand recruits. It's not. There's no purpose to it, really.
Yeah.
I think Lancebearer is worse than Abusive Sergeant in almost every way. Because Abusive Sergeant is a 2-1, which is better than a 1-2. It could be played on 1 as a 1. Against certain classes like Shaman and Hunter. Even though the Lancebearer, the attack buff is permanent, it doesn't really matter because most of the time you're using the attack buff to trade.
Right.
And even if you don't use it to trade and you just happen to use it on the face, you still have the 2 attack from the Abusive Sergeant, which it makes up 1 because this one has only 1. So I can't see this card being played other than just because Abusive Sergeant exists. Bone Guard Lieutenant, probably too slow. I mean,
it's gonna die before you even get anything on it, I feel.
Even a 2-mana 3/3 is not even that good to justify using. Like, no amount of hero powers is gonna be able to make up the fact that all you got is 1 health. So, I don't think it's that good. Flame Juggler is pretty good. It's it's just like Arjun or Horse Rider. It can work both ways. Like, it could be anti-aggro and pro-aggro. I think overall it's a good card. It's probably top-tier card in Arena. Maybe.
Maybe. I don't really like Attendee that much.
I think Tournament Attendee is okay. I mean, it's just... I don't know, like, it's really simple and... Like, it lacks any type of creative design, but...
It works with Bolster, so that's good.
It works with Bolster, even though I would not put it in my deck with Bolster. It's better than Northshire Footman. I'd play this over Northshire Footman. That card is terrible. But just because I prefer 2-1s to 1-2s, because 2-1s can trade up into annoying shit like Knife Juggler.
But then again, if they have a Knife Juggler and you have this on the board, it dies.
True, with but that's, you know, it's just... Also, the other thing is just 2 damages more. So if they don't have Knife Juggler in particular, you can just keep hitting the face for 2. We already know how well 2 mana... I mean, 2 attack, 1 mana creatures do.
Right.
Fucking... Worgen Infiltrator. How many times have we done like 10 plus damage to people with that card? Gadgetzan Jouster, I don't think this is a good card. You might as well just run Zombie Chow. Just because it's more reliable.
Yeah.
And Lily Squire is garbage.
And we're done.
So
we have tokens. We have tokens.
From what I understand, your favorite cards were Evil Heckler and Ice Rager. Got it.
And you love the artwork on Pit Fighter.
I love that artwork.
So initially, like a week ago, my point of view was basically I wasn't going to buy packs because I just didn't like the cards in the set, but other than the Inspire cards, which make up like 1/3 of the set, I think the rest of the set is pretty reasonable, aside from Evil Heckler and Ice Rager and a few others. So I will probably be buying packs. I don't know how many yet. I think I'm going to go approach it with point of view like Alex. I might buy like 20 hit first and see what I get, and then maybe buy another 20.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do, definitely. At least buy 20, because you're not gonna get what you want or anywhere close to it with, I don't know, anything less than that. So
no, if I get a Nubarak and Sky Captain in that 20, I'm not buying anyone. Well,
dude, if I get the Warrior card and Chill Maul in that pack, then I'm not getting any more. Chill Maul? Yeah. I'm getting Chill Maul, so deal with it. And I'll probably just craft Ronan after that.
There are so many legendaries in the set. It's
like, scary. I almost have to get the Warrior one, because that one is pretty broken. We all already decided.
Yeah, I mean, like, I have to get Aviana.
Actually, that's the only one I don't want to get in a pack.
I have to get Ronin.
You don't want to get Varian in a pack?
Nope, I'm crafting him.
You should wait until after the pack.
No, yeah, I'm waiting.
I have to get a Nubarak. I have to get Mistcaller. I kind of want Wolfred Fizzlebang. Definitely want Varian. Sky Captain. The Bane Sisters. Those are basically the legendaries that I want.
Yeah,
I wouldn't mind Ram Shield.
I'll take a Ram Shield, I guess. I mean, like, I wouldn't be upset if I got a Ram Shield or a Gormok.
Or I don't mind a Nubarak either.
Just a car, Ice Howl.
I don't care about the Hunter Legends, I think.
Yeah, you pretty much have to get one with the other. So if you get one, you kind of have to craft the other.
No, I mean, if you, like I said earlier, if you get Dread Scale, it's useful by itself, but the ice, the acid maw, that one, if you get that one, you have to make dread scale.
Right.
But if you get dread scale by itself, I'd play that shit by itself. It's a fucking small baron, get it.
But it's so anti cancer.
Right, but you're gonna play it in control deck, so.
I know, I've been I'm playing cancer right now.
Well, you gotta change that shit up, or play dread scale.
Midrange is pretty good. You should play midrange hunter.
Yeah, I tried that.
I made him a midrange deck.
And I get my ass handed to
him. He said he was losing with it, so he dismantled it and made a face deck.
And you see me winning with the face deck.
Right, so, I mean, what works for me is not always going to work for you, so it's good that you identified the problem and you rectified it all your own. That's what part of playing Hearthstone is about, is self-development.
Welcome to the Cancer Group.
Mm.
I greet you, sir.
Mm.
Yeah, this is not a group I'm ever going to be in. So.
Oh, you'll come around. Don't worry.
You're going to be in the other. You're going to be in the Rogue Cancer deck, the Mill deck.
I know.
That might be a group that I.
So you'll come around. I can tell you. I'll see you soon.
Yeah, if I get the beneath the ground, then I think I'll try to craft a Mill deck.
What's funny is I have all the tools necessary to make the Mill deck.
Oh, I could craft too.
I could craft both of those and just make the Mill deck.
So could I, but I'd rather get it in a pack because I would rather not waste the dust on something that I wouldn't really prefer using.
So cancerous. Gross.
Fucking cancerous. I hate fucking mill decks. Like, I hate playing against them. I mean, I haven't played a mill deck, but I hate playing against them so much.
I know. I started getting texts from you, like, motherfucking mill caster, I beat the shit out of him. Like, oh shit, he's so hyped up. This is not the addicts I know.
Yeah.